हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस यूनिट 2 ऑफ अकाउंटिंग एंड फाइनेंस फॉर बैंकर्स विच इज़ आवर सेकेंड एग्जाम फॉर GIB. सो द नेम ऑफ आवर चैप्टर इज कैलकुलेशन ऑफ YTM. वट इज़ द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ YTM? YTM फुल फॉर्म इज यील्ड टू मेच्योरिटी. सी, सो इन इंट्रोडक्शन फर्स्ट दे आर टेलिंग वट इज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ डेप. Debt means a sum of money due by one party to another party. Debt means we are giving loan to someone, so that is called debt. Here they are saying debt can arise through bank borrowings. Debt means we need some money, we are in need of money, so for that we can take a bank borrowing, bank loan. We can take fixed deposit, bonds or other instrument. Okay, these are the ways by which we can arise debt. Okay, we can arise debt. We need some money, so by this we can do either through bank, by issuing bond. When the amount is fixed or specific and it doesn't depend upon any future relations to settle it. So see, now the thing is, what is bond? Debt consists of mainly bonds and debentures. In debt market, two things are there: bonds and debentures. So both are bonds and debentures. A fixed rate of interest is being paid. Okay, we will get a fixed rate of interest, that is called coupon rate. Coupon rate is the rate of interest that we are getting if we are subscribing any bonds or we are subscribing any debenture. If we are purchasing bonds or we are purchasing debentures. So who is issuing debentures and bonds? Any companies who is in the requirement of fund, who is in need of money, so they can issue debentures and bond. So first thing, is there any difference between bonds and debentures? So yes, there is a huge difference between bonds and debentures. What is that difference? Bonds are some asset backed. These are the asset backed securities. Means if any company will tell like our company assets are this much, like 1 crore, 10 crore, like this, they will tell, then they will issue some bond. In case of debentures, the company, possibly very new company, and that company is already having many other branches, but they are issuing debentures. It means in case of debenture, there is no fixed asset of the company. It is just credit worthiness of the company. People are issuing their debentures. So difference is what? In case of bonds, the company who is issuing the bond, that company will tell that my asset is this much. So people will see that this company is having good asset. And in any case, if anything happens, then by selling the asset, I can get back my money. Okay, for issuing the, for subscribing the bond. So people will think like this, that they are having some security, they are having some assets. Okay, and debentures, company is not having any assets. Based on the credit worthiness of company will issue debentures and people will subscribe, people will purchase debentures. So difference is clear. If asset is there, any security is there, that is called bond. If company is not having any security, just on the credit worthiness of company, they are issuing the debentures and they're saying, thinking that people know that we are a good company, we are a reputed company, and we want loss. We won't make any loss for the people who is subscribing our debenture, who is purchasing our debentures. So based on that, they are issuing debentures. So difference is, these are secured, these are unsecured loan. Both are a type of loan only, no? And in both, you will get, what is the common thing? Common thing is interest, coupon. In both the thing, we will get a fixed rate of coupon, a fixed coupon rate. Okay, some coupon rate, some rate of interest is there. And if anything happens, so we can sue against the company. We can go in court and we can file case against the company if they are not paying our interest. Okay, in both the cases, we can do bonds and debentures. In case of bond, it is secured. Debentures, not secured, unsecured, you can say. So in paragraph, same thing they have mentioned, okay? Bond and debentures, I have clear what is the difference. And that's why it is called less risky in comparison to equity market. In share market, there is more risk. But here you are getting some fixed rate of interest. So this market is less risky, okay? Less risky. And here one thing they have written, see, bondholder can take legal recourse against the company. If you are not getting your amount, you are not getting your coupon amount, your interest, you can take legal action against the company, okay? So these are less risky compared to share market or equity market. The holder of the bond means the person who is purchasing the bond is called creditor or lender, and the issuer of the bond, the company who is issuing the bond, is called debtor or borrower. Okay, this is just a simple definition. Now the terms associated with bonds. What are the terms? What is face value? It is called par. It is also called par value. It is a value of the bond. See, sometimes what happens, फेस वैल्यू इज द एग्जैक्ट वैल्यू ऑफ द बॉन्ड. सी लाइक 100 rupee नोट इज देयर ना. सो दैट 100 rupees दैट इज रिटन इन द 100 rupees नोट दैट इज कॉल्ड फेस वैल्यू. मीन्स वट इज द अमाउंट ऑफ दिस नोट, वट इज द टोटल, वट इज एग्जैक्ट प्राइस, दैट इज कॉल्ड फेस वैल्यू. ओके, समटाइम्स वट कंपनी कैन डू, दे कैन give some discount. Company will say the price of this bond is 100 rupees, but we are giving you discount. In 90 rupees you can take this. Okay, that is discounted value. So face value is called par value, means exact price. Like some shops you are going, they are saying that the price of this biscuit is 5 rupees, but okay, I will give you this biscuit packet for 4 rupees. So what is the exact price? That is called face value or par value. Okay, what is the correct price? What is the price on the face of bond? That is called face value. Second, coupon rate. It, you are getting some specific rate of interest if you are purchasing any bond. Okay, if I am a common customer, any people, and I am interested in any company bond, then company will give me some interest rate every month, every quarter. It depends on what type of bond they are issuing. So that is called coupon rate. Okay, what interest rate I am getting, that is called coupon rate. Next, maturity. A bond is issued for specific period, means I will say that this bond company has issued for 5 years. So that is called maturity, means time, total time period for which the company has issued the bond, that is called maturity period. Okay, time period, total time period. Redemption value, the value when the bond holder gets on maturity, when the time ended. Okay, when the time ended, and what amount I will get on maturity, that is called redemption value, means redemption amount. See, for 5 years I have kept the one for 5 years. After 5 years, what amount I will get, that is called redemption value. Redemption value. Market value. A bond, it can be traded in the stock exchange market. So possibly the face value of bond is 100 rupees, but in market, if a large number of people are interested in that company bond, so demand is more, so price will increase. Okay, price will increase. So the price of that bond will increase from 100 rupees, it may become 110 or 120. That is called market value. What is the market price? Means face value is the exact price of the bond when company is issuing any bond, but market price, based on market scenario, inflations and lot of other factors also, like demand, supply, a lot of things are considered. Based on that, what is the price? That is called market value. In market, what is the price people are willing to pay for this bond is called market value. Up to here it is important. Day count convention, they are just telling that how they are calculating interest. Now, types of bond, how many types of bond? It can be anything, like fixed rate bond. You will get a fixed rate of interest every year, every month, every quarter, depends. Okay, that is called fixed rate bond. Floating rate bonds, means in fixed rate bond, whatever interest in the starting they have told you, for the whole life of bond, for up to maturity, interest rate won't change, coupon rate won't change. That is called fixed rate bond. Floating rate means depends on market scenario. It is variable coupon, means that get change. So based on that, based on scenario, market scenario, the rate of interest will change. That is called floating rate bonds. Okay, fixed rate means rate of interest is same for the whole life, and in fixed rate, sorry, in floating rate, it will change. Zero coupon bond. Zero coupon means they won't pay you any interest. If they won't pay me any interest, then what is the use? Then why I should purchase that bond? They will give some discount. See, they will say the price of bond is 100 rupees, but okay, you take this bond for 80 rupees. Okay, at maturity I will pay back you 100 rupees, so that 20 rupees that I will get extra, that is my profit. Okay, so zero coupon means they won't pay any interest, they won't pay any interest, but they will give you the bond at some discount. If 100 rupees, they will say okay, take at 80 rupees, but at maturity I will get back my 100 rupees, because 100 rupees is the price and company has given me discount in the bond, discount for purchase of the bond. That is called zero coupon, means we won't get any coupon, we won't get any interest, but I will get discount in the starting, at the time of purchase of bond, I will get discount. High yield bond. High yield means when interest rate is very high. These bonds are called junk bonds. It means interest rate is very high, but they are very risky. It means this type of bond are very risky also, but interest rate they will give very high. Okay, low rated companies who are willing to pay high interest rate, because their rating is not good, so risk is more, so nobody will be interested in purchase of their nobody will be interested for purchase of that company bond. Then what company can do? They will give more interest rate, so that people will think, okay, interest rate is more, some risk is there, okay, people can at least think about purchase of those bonds. That is called high yield bond, means interest rate is very high. Convertible bonds means when it these type of bond give bondholder the option that they can convert bond to shares. Okay, the bonds that can be converted to shares is called convertible bond. नेक्स्ट इज इन्फ्लेशन इंडेक्स बॉन्ड इन विच प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट एंड इंटरेस्ट पेमेंट आर इंडेक्स टू इन्फ्लेशन मीन्स इन्फ्लेशन इज कंसिडर्ड इन दिस टाइप ऑफ बॉन्ड अप टू हेयर इज इम्पॉर्टेंट एवरीथिंग वी डोंट नॉट वी नीड नॉट टू स्टडी ओके दिस थिंग नॉट गवर्नमेंट बॉन्ड इशूड बाई गवर्नमेंट डिपार्टमेंट दैट आज कॉल्ड गवर्नमेंट बॉन्ड एंड दिस आर देर इज नो रिस्क ओके perpetual bond perpetual means there is no maturity period okay you will get coupon for whole life there is no maturity date is called perpetual bond bearer bond is a official certificate issued without a name holder means anybody who will hold that certificate that person will be the owner of that bond holder owner of that bond okay bearer means anybody it is a official certificate issued without a named holder any holder name is not there okay anybody who will bear that certificate will be the bond owner means when no specific name that is called bearer bond and subordinate bond are those that have a low priority than the other bonds of the issuer in case of liquidation means subordinate bonds means priority they are not getting they are getting lower priority compared to other bond that is called subordinate Same like asset-backed securities are the bond whose interest and principal are backed by underlying cash flow. Means from another asset you are getting cash flow that works as a security for the bond. That will act as a security for interest and principal payment for the bond that you have purchased. Asset-backed bond. Okay, asset-backed securities. So from here everything I have discussed. See, this is important. Callability and putability. They are asking it. This is one of the most important topic. Okay, callability. See. Some bond give the issuer. Issuer means the person who is issuing the bond. The company who is issuing the bond is called issuer. So some bonds give the issuer the right to repay the bond before the maturity dates on the call dates. Means see any bond is having maturity of 5 years. Okay, but the issuer of the bond, see ABC company is the issuer of the bond who has issued the bond. So ABC company is saying that maturity is 5 years, but okay, I can repay your amount any time before 5 years. Okay, it's not like after maturity only I can pay back your whole money for bond. I can pay it back before that also, before 5 years also, say 3 years, 2 years. So that is called callability. Callability means this gives the issuer the right to repay the bond before the maturity date. What is bond exactly? Bond, you can say a paper. A company is issuing the paper and company is asking people, I am in need of money. You take this paper, give me money. Okay, like you are giving money to your friend or not friend, you can say that any neighbor or anybody else, you are giving money. So on one paper, what you are writing, you are saying that I am giving you 10,000 rupees and you are putting on seal, signature of the person whom you are paying the money and your signature and you are keeping this paper with you. Same concept for bond also. Bond is also a paper which company is issuing. People are taking that paper, people are keeping that paper with themselves and they are giving money to the company. Okay, so in this what is happening, callability means the person is saying that any time means in that maturity period also there, like for 5 years I will pay interest anytime and in the last I will pay back your principal amount. So in callability it gives option, it gives the right, it is a right. Callability and putability is a right. So callability is a right of issuer company and putability is the right of bondholder people, say me, you, anyone. So callability, it is a right of company. What type of right? The right is this: if the company is saying I can pay back your money anytime before the maturity, see, it gives the right, it gives the issuer, issuer means the company who is issuing the bond, the right to repay the bond before the maturity. Means for 5 years they have to pay the interest now. So what company thinks, possibly in 1 or 2 years we will get that much profit and we do not want to pay the interest to the bondholder, we will just repay the whole amount. So that is called callability. Means it gives the issuer the right to repay the bond. Repay the bond means they are paying back the money to the bondholder before the maturity date on the call dates. Means anytime they can call and they can say that this is your amount and maturity is after 5 years or 4 years, but today I am having money, you take this money, that's all. So that is called callability. It is the right of issuer. Putability, it is a right of bondholder. So see, some bonds gives the holder, means it is a type of clause in bond itself, they will mention this clause. For callability also company is mentioning some clause that I am having right in case if I want to pay back your money before maturity also I can pay. So that is called callability. So putability also same, it gives the holder the right to force the issuer, means the person like me, I have taken any bond, I can force the issuer, means any company, to repay the bond before the maturity dates on the put dates. So you got the difference now? Here they are saying in putability that I am the bondholder, I am having the bond, company has issued and I have purchased, but I am in need of money. Possibly in bond maturity date is 5 years, but today I have taken the bonds. Possibly after 1 year, if I am in need of money, so I can force the company. On what basis I have forced? Because I have mentioned one clause of putability. Putability, it give the right to bondholder that they can force a company, force the issuer to repay the bond before the maturity. Okay, before maturity they will ask for money, who? Bondholder. And here, before the maturity, company will pay the money to the bondholder. Okay, it depends. If company is getting more profit, so they can pay off. Here, if bondholder is in need of money, so it can force the company that I need my money back. Maturity is 5 years, okay, but I'm in need of money, so they can force the company. That right is called putability. Okay, this is one of the most important topics, and very frequently they are asking question from these two topic. Okay, 1-1 marks they are asking, so it is very important topic. Now the most important things is starting valuation of bond. See, what is valuation? Means we have to calculate the value of bond. What is the value of bond? I am getting, see with example you can get better idea. They will give you some data, like here also they have given one numerical. You need not to learn this formula, with example directly we will see. Okay, here many things they are saying. Maturity date, everything. So instead of doing this theory and theory, we will directly go to numerical. Okay, this numerical based on this only. Okay, this formula only, this numerical. I will directly tell you how to solve the numerical so that you will get that idea also. See, and this type of question they are asking very frequently, and this is one of the most important chapter. Okay, this type of question, calculate the value of bond, calculate YTM, this type of question they are asking. So first numerical and most important. A bond whose par value is 1000. Par value, face value, same thing. So face value is 1000 rupees. Bears a coupon rate. Coupon rate is 12%. Means 12% rate of interest I am getting. And has a maturity period of 3 years. 3 years is the maturity period of the bond. The required rate of return on the bond is 10%. This is the required rate of return. So what is the value of bond? Like this they are asking. So you have to calculate question like this. See, required rate is 10%. Okay. 12% is coupon rate. 1000 is par value, 3 years is the maturity period. So I have to calculate value of this bond. Okay, what I have to calculate? Value of this bond. For that they have given you one formula, like interest and face value, like this they have given. So see what you have to do, how you have to calculate value of bond. Value of bond, what I have to do? First I have to calculate interest. Okay, first thing I have to calculate interest. 1000 is the face value or par value, you say, and coupon rate is 12%. Okay, 1000 is the face value and 12% coupon rate. So what interest I will get? 1000 into 12% coupon rate. So 1000, 12%, percent you remove and you put 100 here. So what value I will get? 120. So 120 is my interest. Okay, this thing you have to, so first thing you have to calculate interest. Okay, if you want to calculate, you just have to calculate interest. So 120 is my interest. Now the value of bond, this is the formula, you just have to keep in mind, this is the formula. 120 interest you have to write in bracket PVIFA, and what is my rate of return? Required rate of return is 10%. So what I will put? PVIFA 10%, comma, what is maturity period? 3 years. 3 years. This is with interest. Same thing, plus I have to put with face value. What is my face value? 1000 bracket. Instead of PVIFA, I have to put only PVIFA. Okay, A I don't have to put. So PVIF, same 10% required return and comma 3. This is the formula. This is the same formula which is written here. Here now they have told you something. Same thing, I interest, F means face value, and this 1 plus KT, 1 plus KT, and this is the same thing. Now that PVIFA and PVIF is explained here down. See, what is PVIF? Two things I told you, no? With interest you have to write PVIFA, with face value, this is face value 1000, this is my interest amount. Okay, this is my required rate of return, and this is number of years, or you say maturity period. So what is PVIFA and what is PVIF? That I'm going to explain now. See, PVIF, it represents the discounted value of 1 rupee for the period concerned. It is a discounted value of 1 rupees and interest rate. Okay, period and interest rate they have given, interest rate of 10% and maturity period they have given. So PVIFA, it represents discounted value of 1 rupee. Okay, discounted value of 1 rupee for the period concerned and interest rate, while PBIFA represent the present value of ordinary annuity for the period. So it will PBIFA it represent discounted value of 1 rupee and PBIFA represent present value of ordinary annuity. Okay, A means annuity. Okay, present value of ordinary annuity, and it represent present value of discount value of 1 rupee. This is the difference. This is for annuity, present value of annuity, and this is for discount of 1 rupee. Now for PBIF and PBIFA table is given. Table not in this chapter end, it is in after chapter number 3, one table they have given. We are doing chapter number 2, okay? Calculation of ITM is chapter number 2. But PBIFA and PB annuity, see present value of annuity and present value of discounted. This table they have given after chapter number 3. See, this is the after end of chapter 3, which is capital budgeting. Okay, after end of chapter 3, they are giving table here. Okay, so after chapter 2, they are not giving the table. This question we are solving in chapter number 2. At the end of chapter 3, 2 pages they are giving, or you say that before chapter number 4, 2 pages are there. There they are giving the table. This is a table for annuity. Annuity means PBIFA, and this is a table for discount value of 1 rupee, that is PBIF. See, down also they have mentioned. Note, for example, if the interest rate is 10% per year, the present value of 1 rupees received at the year 5 is this. They are just telling that how to solve it. Okay, this I will tell you later, no problem. Here, they are just telling you how to see the table, okay? I will tell you how to see the table. See, here. Say, they are saying if interest rate is 10%, required rate of interest is 10%, and 5 year is my maturity period, okay? 5 year, 10%. So here percentage, it is your interest rate, and here number of years, it is your maturity period, okay? So 10%, 5 year. 5 year, 10%. See, 10% here all percentage, no? So 10% here, this, and for 5 year, this. So where it is getting intersect? 5 year and that 10%. Where it is getting intersect? See, 5 year and 10%, it is getting intersect in 3.791. okay, again I am seeing 10% you put down one line and 5% you put one line here. So where line are intersecting? 3.791. so that's why 3.791. they are just giving you the example how to see the table. If they are saying 5% 2 year, 5% is here, 2 year is here, so how, where it is intersecting? 2 year here, 5% here, so 1.859. if they are saying 2% 3 year, 2% is here, means required rate of interest is 2%, and 3 years is my maturity period. So 3 and 2, where it is intersecting? How you have to see? 2% and 3 year. 2% is here and 3 year is here. So where it is intersecting? 2.884. Like this you have to see, okay? From here you have to make one line. From here you have to make one line. Where it is intersecting, that is my value, okay? For PBIFA, and similar for PBIF, this is the table, okay? They are saying 10%, 5 year. Okay, maturity at year 5. So 10%, where it is? 10% year 5. See, 0.621. So 0.621. like this you have to table, both similar. I think in 10th standard also we used to say see this type of table, no? It is similar to that only, okay? Interest rate in this horizontally and vertically is the number of period. So this table they will give, not fully, whatever data is required they will give. So I have told you how to see the value of PBIF and PBIFA, and what is PBIF and what is PBIFA, that already I have explained you here. PBIFA means present value of ordinary annuity for the time period as well as interest rate, and PBIF is discount value of 1 rupee. Okay, this is simple thing. You need not to that much worry, you need not to worry about getting that much detailed knowledge. Just you have to understand what is PBIF and PBIFA and how to see the table. That's it, that's enough for you. So see, PBIFA this and PBIF this, I have to see the table. Now this is my table, PBIFA. FA means annuity table, okay? This is my annuity table. So PBIFA, PBIFA 10%, 3. This is my PBIFA 10% and 3. See, this is my 10% and this is 3 years. So where it is intersecting? 3 line is here, 10% line is here. So 2.487. So this value 10% 31 is 2.487. This 120 is similar, okay? 120 multiply by this plus 1000 multiply by PBIFA table. I have to see 10% and 3. This is my present value table, PBIF. 10% and 3, okay? this is my 10% and this is 3, where it is intersecting 0.751, okay, 0.751, 0.751. These two value I have taken from table. Now see here, same thing is here in the book. 120 multiplied by 2.487, 120 multiplied by 2.487 plus 1000 multiplied by this 0.751. 1000 multiplied by 0.1. How these two values? These two values from my table, PVIFA table and PVIF table. How to see the table? That I have already told you. Okay, I just have to multiply 120 by 2.487. What I will get in calculator, you can do, you will get 298.44, and 1000 multiplied by 751, I will get 751. I just add the two value, I will get 1049.44. So this is the value of bond. Hope you understand that how to calculate the value of bond. This is the example that I have told you, and this example based on this formula only. Okay, how to calculate this, I have already told you. Simple thing you have to keep in mind. First you have to take interest, then you have to take face value. With interest you have to consider PVIFA, okay, and with face value you have to consider PVIF. What is required rate of interest and what is maturity, that we have to consider. Okay, so required rate of interest is 10% and maturity is 3 years. Simple. Okay, this line is very simple, I have already explained you. And how to see this bracket table, that also I have told you. This is simple calculation. By this we can calculate the value of bond. Okay, with this end of part one of this chapter number 2. Remaining thing I will explain in part 2. By that time you practice it, and thank you so much for watching this video.